Hello everyone, hope you all are well. Today I am going to talk about asking and giving directions. Well, it may happen you don't know how to reach your destination, and then you need to ask someone on the street that how you can get there. On the other hand, any other person may ask you the direction of any place. In that case, instead of using hand gestures, you should clearly and properly tell him the way if it's known to you. Now, first of all, let me tell you how can you ask for direction. Suppose you want to go to Rushikbhitta. You can simply say, "Could you please tell me the direction of Rushikbhitta?" Or, "Could you please tell me the way to Rushikbhitta?" Or, "How do I get to Rushikbhitta?" So these are the three sentences that you can use while asking for the direction of Rushikbhitta. Now, while answering, while you are giving the direction to someone, you can say, "Go left, go right, or go straight." So basically, you are using the verb go and then the direction. Go left, go right, go straight. You can use another verb, that is turn. You can say turn left, turn right. Or you can say take a right turn, take a left turn. Okay. Now the next thing is the use of certain words such as after that, then, next, finally. These are the words that help to break and separate the legs of the route, and the person whom you are giving the direction will get it more easily. Suppose you say, "You go left, after that take right. Next, you will see a grocery store on your left. When you get to that store, you go right. Finally, you will reach your destination." The next thing is the use of landmarks. Now, what are landmarks? The landmarks are the places those are commonly known and are easy to locate. So do use landmarks while giving direction. It would help the person to understand his or her destination more clearly. Like in the last example, I said, "You will see a grocery store on your left." Here, the grocery store acts as the landmark. Now, I am reading out how a conversation between two persons is going on. There are two persons, A and B. A is asking for the direction of Rushikbhitta and B is answering. A: "Excuse me, could you please tell me the direction of Rushikbhitta?" B: "Oh sure, we are at the Dakshineshwar bus stop. From here, please walk straight towards the Kali temple, and just before the main entrance, nearly 100 yards away from it, turn right." A: "Okay, so I have to take a right turn in front of the main entrance." B: "Oh yes, you will find a Mio Amor cake shop and Ganguram sweets on your left. You have to walk further down and you will find Imami Paper Mills factory on your left." A: "So with Imami Paper Mills on my left, do I have to walk straight down?" B: "Yes, please. Finally, you will reach a four-point crossing where you will find Mondol Sweets on your left. There you have to turn right. The second building on your right is Rushikbhitta. Did you get it?" A: "Yes, thank you so much." B: "You are welcome." Make sure that the person you are giving direction to has understood it well. So please ask, "Did you get it all? Did you understand?" So this is basically how you should give direction. And now the last thing that I would like to mention is that It may be the case you don't know the proper direction or you are not sure about the route. In that case, don't just be silent. Okay, tell the person that I'm sorry or I'm afraid I can't help you. You should ask someone else. Please don't guess or don't give wrong direction. It will confuse the person even more. So be nice and sound confident and do your best. It's very easy. Just practice at home and make it perfect. Thank you. Thank you for listening.